The history of cars is also a story about trying to make roads safer. From the first cars to the modern ones we see today, people have been working to reduce accidents and protect drivers and passengers. This video will take you on a journey through time, tracing the milestones and breakthroughs that have shaped the history of the automobile and road traffic safety. From the early experiments with steam-powered vehicles to the modern marvels of autonomous driving, we'll explore the key innovations, technological advancements, and regulatory changes that have contributed to making our roads safer and more efficient over the years. The idea of cars have been around for a long time, dating back to ancient and medieval times. In 1649, Hans Hoch from Nuremberg built a carriage powered by a clockwork mechanism. Later in 1672, Ferdinand Verbeest created a small-scale steam-powered vehicle that couldn't carry people, but was perhaps the first working steam-powered car. The first steam-powered automobile capable of human transportation, named Fardier à vapeur, was built by Nicolas Joseph Cugnot in 1769. One source stated that it seated 4 passengers and moved at a speed of 3.6 km per hour. The second vehicle created by him in 1771 is said to have suffered a mishap during its inaugural demonstration, crashing into a wall in a most unfortunate manner. However, some historians have cast doubt about the veracity of this account, claiming that the first recorded mention of this incident dates back to 1801 and is conspicuously absent from contemporary accounts. In the 19th century, people tried to create steam-powered vehicles. They made improvements like handbrakes and better steering, but laws like UK Locomotive Act of 1865 hindered progress. This law required a person to walk in front of self-propelled vehicles on public roads, waving a red flag and blowing a horn. This slowed down the development of cars in the UK until the law was repealed in 1896. Electric cars were also developed in the 19th century. In 1828, Anjoš Jedlik built a tiny model car powered by an electric motor. Later, in 1834, Thomas Davenport installed an electric motor in a small model car. In the 1880s, electric cars became more popular, with Gustave Trouvet demonstrating a working three-wheeled car powered by electricity in 1891. However, gasoline cars eventually became more popular due to their greater range and quicker refueling times. In 1826, Samuel Brown tested the first industrially applied internal combustion engine, and the first modern car was invented in 1886 by Carl Benz. He built a gasoline-powered car and made several identical copies. Around the same time, Gottlieb Daimler and Wilhelm Maybach formed Daimler Motoren Gesellschaft, which later merged with Benz and C to form Daimler-Benz, the company behind the famous Mercedes-Benz brand. In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, many investors and entrepreneurs started building cars, including Ransom E. Olds, who founded Oldsmobile in 1897. Olds introduced the assembly line, using identical interchangeable parts to produce thousands of cars. However, it was Henry Ford who revolutionized car production with the Ford Model T in 1908, making cars affordable for the masses. Before the invention of traffic lights, police officers were controlling the flow of traffic. For example, in 1722, 3 men were responsible for directing traffic on London Bridge. They used a system of hand signals to guide horses and carriages across the bridge. In 1868, the first non-electrical, gas-lit traffic lights were installed outside the Houses of Parliament in London. These early traffic lights used a combination of semaphore arms and red and green gas lamps to direct traffic. Although they were successful, they had a short operational life and were eventually replaced. In the late 19th century, traffic lights began to spread around the world. These early traffic lights were often semaphore style, with arms that extended to indicate when drivers should stop or go. Fast forward to the dawn of the industrial era, and we find that the earliest recorded fatality related to automobile travel occurred in 1869, when the unfortunate Mary Ward was killed when she fell under the wheels of an experimental steam car built by her cousins in Parsonstown, Ireland. From around 1905 to 1914, in the automotive industry, was a period often referred to as the brass era in the United States due to the widespread use of brass in vehicles during this time. This period saw the development of recognizable and standardized automobiles with the introduction of the modern touring car and the decline of traditional coach-style vehicles. Key developments during this era included the electric ignition system, independent suspension, and four-wheeled brakes. Safety glass also debuted and was patented by John Creve Wood in England in 1905, although it wouldn't become standard equipment until 1926. The high-wheel motor buggy, resembling the horse-drawn buggy, was popular in the United States between 1907 and 1912, with over 75 makers producing them. However, it was eventually replaced by the Model T. This era saw the world's first circumnavigation by automobile, with the 1908 New York to Paris race, as well as the construction of the first South American automobile, the Greve, in Peru. Some notable cars from this period include the 1907 Takuri, the first entirely Japanese-made gasoline engine car, and the 1908-1927 Ford Model T, which was the most widely produced and available four-seated car of its time. In the early 20th century, a significant milestone was reached with the introduction of four-wheeled hydraulic brakes on the Duesenberg Model A in 1922. During this period, the plastic surgeon Claire L. Strait and physician C.J. Strickland began advocating for the use of seat belts and padded dashboards, laying the groundwork for the establishment of the Automobile Safety League of America. In 1912, the first electric traffic light was developed in Salt Lake City, Utah. This light used two colors, red and green, and a buzzer to provide a warning for color changes. The design allowed police and fire stations to control the signals in case of an emergency. The first four-way three-color traffic light was created in Detroit, Michigan in 1920. This light added a third color, amber, to indicate when drivers should prepare to stop. The inventor, police officer William Potts, also added a timer to help coordinate the lights. In the 1920s, cities began to introduce automatic traffic signals. The first company to add timers to traffic lights was Crosshins, which built railroad signals and placed timers in traffic lights in Houston. The main advantage of timers was that they saved cities money by replacing traffic officers. The introduction of automated traffic signals required a change of behavior for pedestrians. Many urban groups welcomed traffic lights, seeing them as more efficient and unbiased than police officer control. The vintage era, which lasted from the end of World War I to the Wall Street crash in 1929, saw the dominance of front-engine cars with closed bodies and standardized controls. This period also saw the development of multi-valve and overhead camshaft engines, as well as hydraulic brakes and automatic transmissions. Notable cars from this era include the 1922-1939 Austin 7, which served as a template for many cars, and the 1924-1929 Bugatti Type 35, one of the most successful racing cars of its time. The pre-war era, which began with the Great Depression in 1930 and ended with the recovery after World War II, saw the integration of fenders and fully closed bodies, as well as the introduction of new saloon sedan body styles with trunks or boots at the rear. Some notable cars from this era include the 1932-1939 Always Speed 20, the first car with an all-synchromesh gearbox, and the 1934-1948 Ford V8, which introduced the flathead V8 engine in mainstream vehicles. The first commercial in-car radio was developed by Paul and Joseph Galvin in 1930. Paul Galvin wanted a memorable brand name for the new car radio, so he coined the term Motorola, an amalgamation of the words motor vehicle and Victrola. The 1930s also witnessed General Motors conducting the first barrier crash test in 1934, marking a crucial step forward in the pursuit of automotive safety. The Hudson Terraplane, introduced in 1936, boasted the first backup brake system, providing an additional layer of security for motorists. The 1940s saw the publication of Dr. Hugs de Haven's groundbreaking study, Mechanical Analysis of Survival in Falls from Heights of 50 or 150 feet, which laid the foundation for future research into automotive safety. The American Tucker, introduced in 1947, was notable for its padded dashboard, middle headlight that turned with the steering wheel, and front steel bulkhead. After World War II, car design changed a lot. One of the biggest changes was the popularity of the pontoon style, where the running boards were removed and the fenders became part of the body. This style was first seen in cars like the Soviet Gaz M20 Pobeda in 1946 and the US Studebaker Champion in 1947. The post-war era witnessed significant advances in safety technology, including the introduction of disc brakes on the Chrysler Imperial Crown in 1949. The 1950s saw the introduction of bumper shocks, and the United Nations established the World Forum for Harmonization of Vehicle Regulations, paving the way for the development of international safety standards. In 1949, the first ignition keys that also operated the starter mechanism were introduced by Chrysler. Before that, cars were often started using a switch or a button, and unlocking the car required a separate key. In the 1950s, cars started to become more powerful and faster, designs became more artistic and stylish, and cars were sold all around the world. Small cars like Mini and Fiat 500 became popular in Europe, while the Volkswagen Beetle continued to be made and sold in many countries. In the US, cars like the Nash Rambler and the Cadillac Eldorado Brougham were popular. The 1940s and 1950s saw the introduction of computerized traffic signals. Computers were used to detect the presence of cars at intersections and adjust the timing of the lights accordingly. One of the earliest examples of computerized control of lights was in Denver in 1952. The first modern-style air conditioning system for cars was introduced in 1953 by Chrysler. It was an optional feature on the 1953 Chrysler Imperial and was called the Air Temp System. This system used a refrigerant to cool the air, which was then blown into the car through vents. The 1960s were marked by significant regulatory changes, including the mandatory installation of front outboard lap belts, padded instrument panels, and white reverse lamps on all new passenger cars sold in the United States. The National Traffic and Motor Vehicle Safety Act of 1966 was a watershed moment in the pursuit of automotive safety, as was the establishment of the United States Department of Transportation and the National Transportation Safety Board. In the 1960s, the US car industry started to face competition from imported cars, and Japanese companies like Toyota and Nissan began exporting their cars to other countries. American companies like General Motors and Ford responded by making smaller cars, and the pony car style became popular with cars like the Ford Mustang. In the 1970s, car design continued to change with a focus on safety, fuel efficiency, and environmental concerns. Small cars like the AMC Gremlin and the Chevrolet Vega became popular, and the station wagon became a popular body style. Japan became a major player in the car industry, and cars began to be made in new countries like South Korea and Brazil. In the 1970s, saw the introduction of airbags as an optional feature, with General Motors offering them on certain models. The National Highway Traffic Safety Administration began crash testing popular cars and publishing the results, and the world's first rear-facing child seat was developed by Volvo. During the 1980s, several safety features were introduced, including anti-lock braking systems and airbags, which became standard equipment in many cars. The 1980s also saw the widespread adoption of fuel injection, which replaced carburetors and improved fuel efficiency and performance. Additionally, the introduction of advanced electronic systems, such as digital dashboards and trip computers, enhanced the driving experience. The 1990s saw the introduction of advanced airbag systems, including side airbags and curtain airbags, which significantly improved passenger safety. Additionally, the 1990s witnessed the development of traction control systems, stability control systems, and anti-skid braking systems, which enhanced vehicle stability and handling. The 1990s also saw the rise of luxury SUVs, with models like the Mercedes-Benz M-Class and the Lexus RX 300 gaining popularity. Furthermore, this period marked the beginning of the hybrid era, with the introduction of the Toyota Prius in 1997, which pioneered the use of electric gasoline hybrid powertrains. Countdown timers on traffic lights were introduced in the 1990s. Timers are useful for pedestrians to plan whether there is enough time to cross the intersection before the end of the walk phase, and for drivers to know the amount of time before the light switches. The 2000s saw the widespread adoption of advanced safety features such as lane departure warning systems, blind spot detection, and automatic emergency braking. Additionally, this period saw the introduction of advanced infotainment systems, including touchscreen displays and Bluetooth connectivity. In the 2010s, the automotive industry shifted its focus towards electrification, with the introduction of battery electric vehicles, like the Nissan Leaf and the Tesla Model S. This period also saw the widespread adoption of advanced driving assistance systems, including adaptive cruise control, lane centering, and automatic parking systems. In the 2010s, the European Union introduced new safety regulations, including the mandatory installation of electronic stability control systems and the revision of general safety regulation. The mandatory installation of e-call systems and reverse cameras also became widespread. In the 2020s, the automotive industry is witnessing a rapid transition towards electrification, with many car makers committing to fully electrify their lineups in the coming years. This period is also marked by significant advancements in autonomous driving technology, with the introduction of Level 3 and Level 4 autonomous vehicles. The 2020s are also seeing the widespread adoption of advanced materials like carbon fiber and aluminum, which are being used to reduce vehicle weight and improve fuel efficiency. Today, cars are more efficient, powerful, and safe than ever before, and the industry continues to evolve.